Yeah. Yeah. Yeah, I think so. All right. All right. My name is Jonathan Goldschmidt. Welcome to the girls' tennis match at Oyster Bay against Hicksville. Brendan, would you like to say any words?
It's a great day for tennis out here. Hope everybody's very competitive and so for the best.
So on the first court here, we have first singles. They're just getting ready right now, practicing. And
look very good.
Looking very good right now. Looking to be a competitive match, and we'll get back to you when it's about to start.
Hicksville has won the first set here in the match.
Great play by both teams here. Both players. Very competitive. On a side note here, we do have the famous school photographer Elijah, who's on the premises today to take some amazing photos. We will have him for an interview on as a guest as soon as possible. Hicksville is now up 2-1 in this singles match. And that's a fault right there. Great play by both players here. Nice rally. Oh, that was indeed in. Brendan, would you like to say anything?
Great play by both players over here. Very entertaining game.
Great insight by Brendan O'Brien. 15:30. I don't think photographer Eli understands how tennis works. And the serve from Oyster Bay. Ooh, and that's out. That was a great rally there. You know, we're trying to be as quiet as possible over here, you know. Photographer Eli's in the corner. Taking flicks of Brendan. Would you like to stay high and step in? He's doing his work. He'll be on an interview later. Oh, wow, what a save over there by the Hicksville player. Oh, it hits the net. Point for Hicksville. We will be back momentarily. And now I am joined by photographer Eli. So, Eli, what would you like to say to the people?
Hello, BTV. You know, I've been really looking forward to an interview like this. You know, I've been a photographer for Oyster Bay for a while now, you know. It's been about a year, and I'm really thrilled for this new season, you know. We've got volleyball, football, tennis, you know, soccer, boys and girls. I'm really just soaked to really be a part of this whole thing, you know. I've got some new skills in my my bag. I've got some new gear I'd love to use.
Right, I saw that, yeah. So, yeah. Eli, how do you pick a school game to go to? Like, what is your thought process and what do you want to shoot that day?
Well, you know, of course, I pick and choose my favorites. But, you know, I like to cover everything. I pretty much covered every sport. But, you know, if you look, you know, on my social media, EPPhoto1K on Instagram, you know, you'll see I tend to favor a lot towards baseball and football, you know.
Right.
A lot of the sports just have a lot of emotion. Even soccer, I mean, you know, this fast-moving, fast-paced sports that really just give me a challenge, you know. I'm just really interested in those.
Right, great insight there. And we got to say big thanks to Mr. Bremhoff letting you know, get down real close to the field.
You know, Mr. Bremhoff, he's our new AD, you know. He's really given me a really good opportunity as a photographer. You know, he's given me on-field action, you know, access to all the games, away games, media passes, all of that, you know. So big shout-out to him.
Right, yeah. So, what else? What is there to say? I mean, just amazing, amazing work.
Yeah,
so, here's another question. So, during basketball season, what's going to happen? You know, you're a star basketball player. Who's going to be taking the pictures?
You know, I am a player on the team. You know, I am looking for an apprentice right now. You know,
really?
So to take my role while I'm out there on the court, you know. So, I mean, anybody watching this, I mean, you can drop a comment down. You know, we can
comment, DM at what Instagram? Anything. What's your Instagram handle again?
EPPhoto1K.
There you go.
Again, at EPPhoto1K.
Anybody watching this interested in, you know, taking pictures for the basketball team during the winter season? You know, let them know.
And, you know, we could do a couple practice shoots, you know, really get the hang of it. I've got a variety of lenses, you know, stuff to really get, you know, somebody new into the photography game, you know, really acquainted with it. So, you know, I just shout at me, you know, I'd love to give a chance, an opportunity.
All right, amazing. Thank you, Eli. Appreciate it.
Thank you, OBTV.
So we're here at Feature Court 1. We have a score update. Hicksville is up 4-3. That sound right? So, Brendan, I'm going to ask you for your analysis right here on what's happening in this. Definitely see that. You know, these players have put a lot of work in. You tell, you know, we're only showing off here one court of the four, and there's other people not playing, but everyone, I could look around, you know, they'll put their work in here.
Exactly. They're all trying their hardest. And that's all right. You can ask for.
Yep. That's amazing. So, you know, good try by our Oyster Bay player, but Hicksville takes a set. You know, great play by both. You could tell how much they put in the work. You know, these are their best players here. You know, we got photographer Eli taking great pictures. Going to post it on Instagram later tonight. Will you? No, not later tonight, you know. Eventually. So, Eli, what could we look forward to tomorrow? Or Brendan. Brendan, what can we look forward to tomorrow, Brendan?
Tomorrow.
All right, we got Eli now.
Hey, guys, EP Photo here. What are we looking forward to tomorrow?
Yeah.
There's actually a great volleyball game. I think their second one of the season, their first home game, 6:45. I mean, it's great. You know, volleyball was one of the first sports I started shooting, and honestly, I fell in love with it. So, you know, I'm really excited for it to be coming back, you know. And, you know, they've got some new talent coming in. You know, I really love volleyball. It's actually one of Worcester Bay's best sports, along
right,
with you know
last
baseball,
year.
Softball. You know, it's just great. It's a great experience.
Last year, tell me if I'm not correct here, they won the county championship?
Yes, they did.
Against East Rockaway, right?
I believe so. I was actually there at that game.
That was really there as well.
Game. I was there at their really bad loss at LIU.
Right.
In the I'm not sure which game that was, but it was a great game. It was a hell of a game, really.
Right.
You know, I'm really looking forward to what these girls are really gonna give us this year. You know, we've lost a few players. You know, Caitlin Kelly, Caitlin Ashon. You know, these great players, but I believe that our volleyball team. We'll win states.
Wow. Hot take coming from photographer Eli. You know, I've seen this team play. You know, the seniors graduated, but they still got the same core. So I do think they will win. I think at the request of Mr. Bramoff, we will be broadcasting that tomorrow night.
Yes.
I do not know what time. But, so for on court one here, Hicksville does take the win. Pretty sure there will be more matches coming up, though. Stay tuned. All right, so we are back. Eli, what would you like to say about what's going on in the match? You know,
on the singles court right now, we've got Hicksville in the lead. They are a point up right now, and they have a set. You know, I'm really looking forward to Oyster Band, what they're going to do next.
Yeah, try to come back.
Yeah, we need this one.
We do need this one, you know. I don't know. Can't tell what the rest of the you know, the matches are going on.
Right,
hopefully they're winning,
here.
But, you know, these are two of the best tennis players, you know, right now. All right. Okay.
Looks like we got some new competitors hopping on. We've got Anna Pace and Kate Webster hopping off the court, hopping off the doubles court right now. We've got Olivia Gallo and Lexi Paradiso hopping on the doubles now. We're looking forward to this duo. You know, ever since the tennis season started, you know, really, really, really high hopes for them.
All right, we'll be back. You know, we're gonna try to get some interviews from some players on. Yeah, so we'll be back with those. Well, you know, we're going to get some scouting. We got Ian Lubin right next to me. He's going to try to get some interviews for us.
Ian Lubin, our class president.
Class president, actually. Would you like to give him the mic really quick?
Please, Lubin, please.
Class president? Please. Class president?
Hello, John. Hello, Eli. I am here. I am seeing our tennis match, and it is looking well, promising. We have multiple teams I would believe that are doing well. And I love to see how this goes.
So, yeah, Ian, we're actually losing, but, you know, it's a, you know, I'm enjoying it out here right now. It's a nice temperature. Great, you know, great day for tennis, you know. So, do you think you can get some players from over there?
I believe so. Mariana should be joining me shortly, so I can probably get her onto a solid interview. Probably Kaplan Webster or Robin Glazer, too.
Okay. All right, thank you. We'll be back with the interviews shortly. Oyster Bay is up 3-2 in this set. Rose is playing very nicely. Great rally, as you saw the last one right there. Amazing play by both of them. Brendan, any insight?
Well, I would just have to say I'm very impressed by both of these players. Both of these players are playing very well right now, and this game is very interesting to watch. Can't wait to see more. Right. Back to you, John.
All right, yeah, you know, taking a little break right now. Got to stay hydrated. You know, it's still a little hot out, even though it's September.
Yeah, the weather's been beautiful.
It has been beautiful. You know, this court was filled with water. I'm very surprised it actually is dry right now.
Yeah, great job by Mother Nature.
All right, Brendan. Thank you for that. Appreciate it. All right. Sorry for the technical difficulties there. You know, our hotspot left to go to the bathroom. So we're back now. So, yeah. Keep watching. Thank you very much.
All right, on the second court here, we've got a doubles match with Mariana and Savannah Gallo. Actually, the little sister to our great player, Olivia Gallo. You know, Olivia Gallo's a junior now. You know, maybe we could see them playing doubles together next year. That'd be actually pretty interesting to see. You know, sister-sister duo, that'd be great. Meanwhile, we've got a... Rose.
That was a fault right there. Yep. Oh, nice. Oh, the ball's in the middle of the court. This ain't a problem. That's in. Great save there. The loft ball right there. Candy. That was in. Oh, wow.
Wow.
Oh, is that in? That's out. Amazing. Amazing. She did not see that.
No. You know, Rose's ability to just track that ball in the air and just attack it is amazing.
Could you say she is the best tennis player on this team?
That's a hot take to make, John, but she might be.
Yeah, well, you know what? Very happy with this. Brendan O'Brien does not want to talk for some reason.
What?
I would love to get him on the mic, but you know he's a little camera shy, even though he's not in front of the camera.
What are you talking about?
But whenever this does end, I think we had some players agree, did we not, Eli, to have an interview?
Yeah, Catherine Webster is actually supposed to we've invited
to pop
her
in, yeah.
To pop in for an interview, so that'll be exciting. She's she was over there playing doubles with Anna Pace, you know.
I think we might need to have Rose on here, too.
True. I mean, Rose.
She has been showcased the whole entire.
Really, just tearing it up over here in the singles.
Right. So how? You know what? All right. We'll let you know when this set is over and when what's going on. We'll be back.
All right, deuces.
Oyster Bay wins this set, and now the score is all tied up at one, and they're going into the third set for the tiebreaker.
So Rose did just win that set, so it's tied 1-1 in sets, and this is now for it all.
This is for game.
This is for game here. So we are going to be watching on. This is the premier matchup of the day here. That's why you're on it. Big
moment.
This is a big game here. Keep it in the air. Look at this rally.
It's like a lot of Oyster Bay Open. Whoever wins this wins the Open.
That's amazing, Brennan.
Thank
That's
you.
A great joke.
Appreciate that.
A lot of lob balls here, you know.
Oh, just that.
Then they got. Did he get stuck in the fence? Wow, this is a moment here. This is
incredible.
This is a moment of Bayman TV here. The ball, the tennis ball, just got stuck in the fence. But Rose was trying to hit it.
Yeah, that was a little bit out of the reach.
That was a little earlier, you know. I just want to shout out Brennan's dad.
That is very uncalled for.
What's up, Mr. O'Brien? What's up, Mr. O'Brien? How you doing? All right, we'll be back.
Oyster Bay takes the first game in the final set. Let's prepare for the second game right here.
All right, we're back here.
Hello, Bama TV. EP Photo here.
All right, we're at, saying middle set. Not really middle set, but, you know, we're back with an update.
Rose with a strong swing. Wow.
Yes, yes, it indeed was. Nothing. Yes, 1-0 in the third set here. This is the final set.
Moving down to the second court, we've got Mariana and Savannah.
Yep.
Still battling it out. They're actually up set right now. They've been playing their hearts out.
Oh, here we go. And that was out. Great point by Rose. So, Eli, I got a question for you, right?
What's up, John?
What makes you want to do photography?
You know, photography's always been, you know, a part of my life since a young age, you know. Parents got me into it. You know, always had a little Polaroid or whatever. First got my first DSLR camera. Actually, a couple years ago, you know, I started shooting little events and everything. And I wanted to upgrade, you know. So I went to a football game. Didn't have, you know, the most gear or anything, you know, the most experience, but, you know.
You know, those pictures are still great.
Yeah, I mean, I worked my way up, you know, upgraded my gear progressively, right. You know, and I just got better at my craft, and I'm still not at the top yet, you know. I've still got a lot of room to improve, you know.
Right. So not only do you do these schools, sports teams pictures, you also do weddings, right?
I do weddings on the side, yes. I do ceremonies, events, all that type of stuff, you know. I mean, if you're looking for somebody, I can conquer it, you know. I love sports, you know. You see my Instagram, it's a bunch of sports, but I also do events and everything, so, you know.
Right. Yeah.
I like to keep my portfolio versatile.
Versatile, yes. I do enjoy that. Oh, and are we getting a live score update?
Nice.
So, I'm getting some word back from our producer. Rose is up 2-1 in the final set here, which is a very good sign for Oyster Bay.
Great.
Yeah, so hoping she gets the dub right now, but you know, the Hicksville player is playing very well right now. That you can tell they're both getting a little tired here, you know, they've been playing for a long time. Alright, we'll get updates back to you.
right there.
All right, so we do have a score update for you. Rose for our Oyster Bay girls tennis team is now winning 3-2 in this set.
We are entering the backhand of this set.
Yes. Oh, interesting. What just happened there?
Just caught off the end of the racket there, yeah. Jonathan.
All right, so as you said, we are entering the backhand. This is, it's getting dark out.
It's crunch time back here.
Crunch time. So, we're hoping to get Rose on for an interview.
Hopefully.
Win or lose. Hopefully she wins. Hopefully. Get her on.
That would be the best idea.
Playing great. The stamina is there, really.
100%.
The stamina is there. The stamina is also there for photographer Eli, who's been around, has been around the court. Again, Instagram tag ePhoto, EPphoto1K. On Instagram,
John,
go check it out.
I have a question for you.
Okay.
How many times are you going to plug in Elijah's Instagram?
You got to support him.
That's a great question.
He's doing this for free, right?
Right.
He's doing it on his own time, Brendan.
That's a good point.
So you got to give him the support here because, right when he gets out of the school, he's got to make a living, right?
That's a great point.
So,
I'm not, downing.
All I got to say, is his book the man.
Yeah, it's just.
Give him a little DM. That's it. Little DM, he'll be right there.
On the spot.
All right, we'll be back. We'll be back with an update soon. This will be ending pretty shortly. Thank you for staying with us for the whole time, if you are watching.
Yeah. Hey, Mr. Goldschmidt, how you doing?
Oh, shout out from Brendan. Shout out from Brendan. Hi, Dad. All right.
How you doing, Mom and Dad?
All right, how are we doing? All right, goodbye. All right, quick little score update. As you can see on the screen, Rose is winning 5-2.
Yeah, it's very close.
So, well, Brennan, from your acknowledgement here, we're one game away from winning the whole thing, eh?
If I believe so, John. I believe that is correct.
All right.
I'm not the brightest with tennis, but I'm pretty sure.
Well, me neither. You know what, though? I'm learning, and I'm loving to learn it, you know?
Yeah.
All right. I will be back
as you guys watch this. The game is over.
All right, so we just got a surprising, I mean, not surprising, great player, but got a score update here. So it is now 5-4 to Rose. It was just 5-2. And this is the final set, so, you know, she's working hard. Yeah, so we'll get back to you. So we are now with our athletic director, Mr. Bramoff. Mr. Bramoff has an announcement for us.
All right, Bayman Nation, we're here at the tennis match, so forgive me if I'm whispering. I'd like to make a major announcement regarding next week's football game. On Friday, the 23rd, we are going to be hosting a night football game against Valley Stream South. I want everybody to wear glow-in-the-dark apparel. We're going to light up the night. Once again, the football game from Saturday the 24th has been moved to Friday night home game under the lights. The game will start at 7 p.m. So we're going to use that momentum that we're going to get during homecoming week, and we're going to carry it right over into light up the night on the 23rd. 7 o'clock down at TR. Be there.
Great. Thank you. So we do have another score update. Rose is losing a little bit, but, you know, she'll be okay. You know, it's 5-5 now. This is, I'm pretty sure, by Brandon told me, is the set point here. Set point. This is the last game of this. You know, it's getting dark out. Hopefully you guys can still see, but we'll let you guys watch and enjoy. So we got some interesting news here, apart from Mr. Bramos' news. We do have a tiebreaker right now. Going on right now. Brennan, would you like to say how this is possible?
Yes, well, Rose won that last set, so it puts you up 6-5. But, oh, hold on.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Appreciate it. Got
it. All right.
6-6. That's not fully done. It's 6-6 right over there, yeah.
Okay. So
as Rose just came over and told us.
Yeah, it was
probably
very
a tiebreaker.
Nice of her.
Thank you. You know, we're just playing. I think it's whoever wins now. Whoever wins this game, I think.
Yeah, I think this is
whoever,
it.
Yeah, because I think it was supposed to be won by two, but, you know.
But scored 6-6. I'm pretty sure it's just 1-7. So
right,
whoever
right,
wins
right.
this next game is the champion.
Right. All right. Enjoy. So it is over. Brendan, would you like to say who won?
Hicksville will take the win for this tennis match.
Yes,
today.
Hicksville. Wow, this was over 2 hours.
Over two hour match.
We would just like to say thank you for watching. We will see you tomorrow for the volleyball game at 6:45 tomorrow, and I will be commentating with an unknown partner that you will find out there. All right, thank you very much. Appreciate it. Have a good night, Yellow.